I'm delightful to introduce our second speaker, Professor Mamata Dadala, Professor, Head Department of Sericulture, Fulbright Scholar USA, Registrar of Sri Padmavati Mahila Viswavidyalaya, Tirupati, AP, India. Ma'am will be taking a session on resources for teaching science. Dr. Mamata is a Fulbright Scholar and an alumnus of Professor Bruce Hammock's lab, University of California, Davis, USA. She has 22 years of teaching and research experience. On 26 November 2016, she assumed charge as Registrar of Sri Padmavati Women's University, Tirupati, AP, India, which is the first university of women in the state and second in nation. She is also an alumnus of NIEPA, National Institute of Educational Planning and Administration, New Delhi, and Hagai International Leadership Training Institute, Hawaii, USA. Dr. Mamata specialized in molecular biocontrol of insect pests, applications of DNA barcoding for automated recognition and conservation of biodiversity, silk biomaterial development, and computational biology. As a principal investigator and collaborator, Dr. Mamata has completed 7 multidisciplinary research projects, major, and 3 international collaborative research projects with a research grant of ₹299 lakhs, and 2 projects are going on, and 4 more projects are in pipeline. She has worked in collaboration with University of California, Stanford University, USA, and Cairo University and Zagazig University, Egypt. Under her guidance, 3 PhDs were awarded and 2 postdocs were completed. 5 PhDs are ongoing. She published more than 30 research peer-reviewed publications, published 1 patent and 1 patent filed, authored 3 books, and contributed 7 chapters in various books from reputed publishers. As a registrar, she is also instrumental in getting major institutional grants to the tune of ₹66 crores for the establishment of centralized facilities in the campus, like DST Technology Business Incubator, DBT BioNest Biotech Incubator, Kelo India Sports Multipurpose Hall, and MSME Livelihood Incubator. She has also initiated admin reforms like e-office, payment gateway system, office automation, blended mode of education, and paved the way for the implementation of NEP 2020 reforms like multi-entry, multi-exit with 3+1+1 UG, honors, and PG programs, and also in the process of obtaining the Meru status to the university. Dr. Mamata played a significant role in the upgradation in the university administration, like getting pension granted to the non-teaching staff, resolving long pending service matters and grievances of the teaching and non-teaching staff, which led to the quality working environment and rise in turnover capacities of the employees. Professor Mamata is a member in several prestigious bodies, committees like member selection committees for IIT, University of Mysore, DBT Central Compliance Committee, DBT Nominee, IBSC, Research Advisory Board Standing Committee, Executive Council of SPMVV, and NAC Peer Team Member 2. She's also a member in Board of Studies for several universities, Board of Examiners and Board of Studies for Universities of Mysore and Bangalore. She's also on the editorial board for Springer Journals, CBE Journals, and Bioinformatics India Journals. Dr. D.M. Mamata is the recipient of WHO Achievement Award 2006, DBT Young Scientist Award 2007-8, Lifetime Award 2008 by the International Institute for Ecological INSA, National Academic Summer Research Faculty Award 2009 and 10, Best Research Paper Award by IJASR 2013, US Fulbright Fellowship 2014, Research Excellency Award by Indo-US Foundation 2016, Best Teacher Award by the Lions Club International 2017, are some of the major significant awards received for her contributions to the body of knowledge of science and technology. We welcome you, ma'am, and request you to take over.
Thank you, Dr. Sunita. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is the second time I'm meeting the St. Francis College for Women, Hyderabad.
Yes, ma'am. And,
thank you so much and inviting me once again. It's a privilege for me to meet you all on this platform. Being from Women University, meeting the women and sharing the knowledge of science and technology, I feel I'm always privileged and I could share my bit of my knowledge to the young women that are from your institute too. Well, this is an era of virtual learning. Well, the COVID-19 pandemic has changed the education forever. It has really resulted in the closure of schools, colleges, and higher education institutions and universities across the world. Nearly, as per the UNESCO reports, nearly 1.2 billion students from 86 countries are out of classrooms. And as a result, education has changed dramatically with a distinctive rise of e-learning, whereby teaching is undertaken remotely or on the digital platform. We can even see the graph that has been reported by the UNESCO. It is a very, very sudden, complete game change, especially for the educational field. Well, with the sudden shift away from the classroom in many parts of the globe, some are wondering whether the adoption of online teaching will continue to persist post-pandemic and how such a shift would impact the worldwide education market. Well, even before the COVID-19 has already a high growth in adoption education technologies, the global edutech investments have reached $18.66 billion in 2019, and overall market on the education project are going to reach by $350 billion by 2015, be it in language apps or the virtual labs or the video conferencing or online learning softwares. That has really created a significant surge since the COVID-19. At the same time, this online education has brought in several advantages also in terms of flexibility of learning, in terms of flexibility of, spacing the time of learning and accessibility at global platform. Let's see certain of the benefits of this online education from a student point and also from the teacher's point of view. We'll see the first one is the flexibility. Any student can attend the classes and courses anywhere with a computer and access to the internet. This is a major feature for this one. And the next is the accessibility. And, online course materials can be accessed 24 hours a day and almost every day too. And the next is the global knowledge, wherein this knowledge is limited in the textbooks. The global knowledge can be reached by the students and shared by the instructors around the globe, which cannot be learned through the textbooks because the limitations are there, the limitations have been crossed over. Well, it's a student-controlled study time. This is another added advantage. Students may not have to sit for long periods of time. Lessons can be paused when needed and notes read at their will. Next, change. It gives us a great chance for interaction. Online courses may be less intimidating than the traditional classroom setting, but it could help increase in the student interaction, which otherwise would not have been reached out in a traditional classroom setting. Well, it is very cost effective. And last time when I came, I flew to the Hyderabad and I had to deliver it. And now I'm able to, attend to my duties here right from my office. I was able to meet all the same platform. That is how cost effective it can be. We can reduce a lot of costs. And now the actual essence of education is going to be reached to each and everyone. Each and everyone who is really interested to learn, committed to learn and looking forward to upgrade themselves. Well, it offers a lot of savings because there is no additional cost on transportation and accommodation and other incidents too. And it gives a better opportunity. Students are given the opportunity to choose from various schools and from different countries too. And in addition to that, it is student-centered. Every student has his or her way of learning that works for them. So with all these benefits, Yes, though it has been started way back in at least 2 days, before, and now the necessity has been felt by each and everyone in the field of education, and now everyone has started depending on the online education, and let's see how the government efforts have been made in order to meet this demand. Well, the term MOOCs, we heard the term MOOCs in this last 5 years, but the actual impact has been felt only ever since the COVID-19 started taking over us. And it has been developed by Stephen Downes and George Siemens, entitled Connectivism and Connectivity Knowledge in 2008. The original concept of MOOCs is to break down obstacles to education for everyone, anywhere, at any time. So this massive open online course is a model for delivering learning content online to a large number of people. These are online courses which are courses with unrestricted number of participation and with open accessibility. And now the necessity has been felt, and in the current pandemic times, and the credibility has been greatly appreciated. And had we not started the MOOCs, things would have been a different thing, in more searching, and now the people would have been started designing in ourselves. But since we have MOOCs since 2008, though it has been not very seriously felt, now we can actually feel the pulse of it. And now I'm going to get into the various resources and also the flexibility in reaching out to the resources. Well, the MOOCs, availability to attract many aspiring youth in India, and also has initiated a good number of MOOC platforms. Some of the MOOCs available in India are, one is the Swayam. It is from the MHRD, Government of India effort, and the NPTEL, these are the effort from IITs and IISCs, and MOOC Kit, this is from IIT Kanpur, and IIT Bombay X, it is an effort from IIT Mumbai, and IIM BX, it is from IIM Bangalore, and Agriculture MOOCs, AG MOOCs, it is an effort from the IIT Kanpur. Let's get into a little more detail of this one. Well, SWAYAM is an acronym which stands for the Study Webs of Active Learning for Young Aspiring Minds. It is an Indian chapter of massive open online courses. It is indigenously developed by IT platform. The very word acronym itself speaks to us. It is SWAYAM. It is built by us. Developed by IT platform, initiated by the Government of India, which is instrumental for self-actualization, providing opportunities for a lifelong learning. And it is an integrated MOOCs platform for distance education that is aimed at offering all courses from school level to PG level. Well, if you see the various courses and various platforms, it's an NPTEL, they cover more of the engineering aspects, and UGC for the post-graduation education, and CEC, Consortium for Educational courses for the under UG programs from the UG, undergrad education, and NCERT and NIOS for school education, and IGNO, IGNOU for out of the school students, and IIMB for management studies. And they have categorized this way, covering all levels of education sector in our country. And it has four quadrants. And majorly, it is a video lecture session followed by a specially prepared reading material that can be downloaded and printed. And it has self-assessment tests, through tests and quizzes, and an online discussion forum for clearing the doubts. And if you see the NPTEL, it is a project funded by the MHRD, Government of India. And the NPTEL is an acronym, stands for the National Program on Technology Enhanced Learning, which is an initiative by 7 Indian Institute of Technology from IIT Mumbai, Delhi, Guwahati, Kanpur, Kharagpur, Madras, and Roorkee, and the IISc Bangalore for creating online content for engineering and science. It is a project funded by Ministry of Human Resource Development, and And the contents of the courses were based on the model curriculum suggested by AICTE and the syllabi of major affiliating universities in India. This project was first proposed jointly by 5 IITs coming together and IISc for creating content for 100 courses as web-based supplements and 100 complete video courses for 40 hours of duration per course. And this entire portal is powered by Google as a part of their continuing partnership with NPTEL. So the NASSCOM is also a partner in this program. And this member companies such as TCS and CTS have participated in syllabi and content creation. And it has been greatly used by the engineering students of all streams. And it has been a mandatory program also in the current day curriculum for the engineering courses. Well, let's see the MOOCIT. This is a MOOCIT is a management system like edX. It's a lightweight management system like edX, which is conceived, designed and developed at IIT Kanpur. And to deliver and manage a course online since 2012 onwards. And it has built a ground up at the computer science department, IIT Kanpur, with the best of breed features of the state of art technology. And it has learners and architectures, you know, which is highly customizable and very cost effective. It was made very cost effective. And according to IIT Kanpur, the underlying principles of MOOCIT are to ensure learning is not a fatigue. Learning should scale and create online courses should easily and made easy by taken by the students. And as of now, the institution ties up with IIT Roorkee to jointly give students who successfully complete the ARC4 cloud course certificates of accomplishment while providing learners completing its MOOC course with the certification of participation. Well, if you see the IIT Bombay X course, it is also a MOOC platform developed by IIT Mumbai through significant customization of an open edX code base. It is also an integration of Drupal 8 with OpenEdX, and the courses are offered using OpenEdX while Drupal is used to fetch and display the courses in various ways. And this platform has been created for learners, including academicians, students, researchers, professionals, administrative staff, and novice users, including educationally, socially, academically, physically disadvantaged groups, and others that seeks to transform themselves through cutting edge technologies, innovative pedagogy, and also the rigorousness of the courses. The basic aim of IIT Bombay X is to become a leading resource for learners through focused goals and principles, thus imparting quality education at scale. And further to see the key features, you know, it captures the benefits of flipped classrooms, online lectures, live interactions with IIT Mumbai X course instructors, and it offers 4 types of MOOCs for various learning needs: Edu MOOCs, Skill MOOCs, Teach MOOCs, and Life MOOCs. So everything is very specially designed to meet the needs of the student so that accordingly they can choose from which they want to get equipped in their academic lines. Well, if you see the BX course, it's yet another MOOC course founded on the philosophy that management education has strong potential to transform our educational system and that high quality education must be available to all unconstrained by limitations imposed by location, finances, or prior educational background. The vision of IIMBX program is to use digital learning to enable widespread access to the management education. The MOOC led is by the faculty at IIM Bangalore. It offers online courses and programs covering core and advanced business and management subjects. And further, online programs by IIMBX use technology to enable anytime, anywhere learning in a global classroom. It offers management education using technology to learners through a well-balanced mix of multimedia courseware designed to bring life to the IIM Bangalore classroom experience in a virtual form. And instructionally designed mix of lecture videos, online quizzes, multimedia cases, references, further readings, forum interactions, live sessions, together contribute towards an effective and engaging learning experience that is flexible and self-paced. And students by this kind of platform are greatly benefited. Well, yet another one is an AgriMOOCs. It's an agriculture massive open online courses. It's an online course for anyone and everyone interested in agriculture. It is a consortium led by IIT Kanpur, and other members include the Commonwealth of Learning and Indian Institute of Management, Calcutta, and the University of Agriculture Sciences, Raichur. Well, the MOOCs was developed with an understanding that agriculture is a crucial sector on which India's well-being is dependent upon, and is a sector where the need for the improved skills is greatest and most massive. The platform promises thousands of learners to access high-quality agriculture education in a single offering. This platform further provides free access to numerous high-quality courses offered online by renowned faculty from a premier institute of the country. One can learn learn on their own, which is scheduled, and receive certificates as well on completion. The course is meant for users like students of agriculture university, agriculture scientists, faculty at agriculture universities, agribusiness people and general management students, field officers, extension officers, farming personnel, NGOs in agriculture, and many more. Who wants to learn about the agriculture technologies can always lean on to and access and get themselves educated. Yet another initiative by MHRD is the e-Pathshala. It is under the National Mission on Education through ICT. It is being executed by the UGC. The content and its quality being the key component of education system, high quality curriculum-based interactive e-content in 70 subjects across all disciplines of social sciences, arts, fine arts, and humanities, natural and mathematical sciences. It has three verticals. One is e-Adhyayana, where you have all the e-books reached. And you know, it provides 700 plus e-books for the postgraduate courses. And all the e-books are derived from PG Pathshala courses. It facilitates a big playlist of the video content also. Well, about the UGC MOOCs, it is yet another vertical, and it is one of the, it also based on the PG courses, based on this in the Swayam platform. And it is one of the UGC is one of the national coordinator for the Swayam and InfluNet, and the technical partner is the UGC MOOC. Well, the e-Bhatia is an offline access. It's one of the another vertical of PG Pathshala, which is a software-driven course and a content package that facilitates student pursuing higher education at PG level in distant learning as well as campus learning mode. Yes, it facilitates offline access to the students. Well, from the RUSA, we know what is RUSA. It has been a great initiative of MHRD, and in certain components of the RUSA, certain universities have taken up virtual tutorial projects, and one such project taken up by the Utkal University is here I'm presenting. Well, under RUSA, they have developed this particular portal. In this virtual tutorial project, you have several e-lectures that has been stored up for the UG and PG. And we can see that we have a science videos, latest science videos, and content-wise and topic-wise, you can see them here. And you have 683 science videos were recorded and kept here in that website. And well, you have also similarly, you have other commerce videos. We have 322 commerce videos on different aspects of commerce. Well, on the art subjects, you have nearly 1,116 video lessons were being recorded and been cataloged here. And from this, from the syllabi of PG, curriculum, you can start selecting the subjects from, what it has been given here, from the art syllabus, the commerce, from the sciences, from humanities. You can select them, and you can watch the lecture videos, which has been very finely done and compiled and stored under the RUSA virtual project. Well, coming to IIT Bhubaneswar, in the Central Library, several teaching learning resources have been created under open access e-resources, and several courses were been placed here. We can see them here under Swayam. We have several courses, and Swayam Prabha is a digital courses on TV, and E Acharya, that's a Inflipdet, and E Gyan Kosh, E PG Patashala from Inflipdet, and E Shodh Sindhu, E Yantra, which is meant for engineering for better tomorrow, and Virtual Labs, web-enabled experiment designed for the remote operations, and FOSI is a free library and open source software for education. Yet another one is a spoken tutorial with IT application for National Digital Library of India, and Shodh Ganga, which is a reservoir of Indian thesis, and NPTEL video lectures, and Code Academy, and free lecture videos, and Harvard Open Courseware, and MIT Open Courseware, and other learning resources, and Open AL courses, Oxford Mathematics Open Courses, and other learning resources, and yet video lectures, and Shodh Suddhi, and which is a plagiarism detection software, and research information management system, and ERP, that is Samrat. Yet further resources are also reported from the Central Library. You have a repositories on ebooks and on e-journal databases, and e-journals themselves, you can find them. And you can even have e-print archives. You can find a worth and tons of information, knowledge of information here. And you can even find national repositories here where you can identify the Digital Library of India, National Digital Library of India from IIT Kharagpur, Shodh Ganga, IIT's Council, Vidwan, Vidyanidhi Project, Research Project Database, and Shodh Gangotri. Not only that, you have institutional repositories like CSRNTI, CFTRI, CSIR, Indian Institute of, their repositories, CSIR repositories, you can find a good number of CSIR repositories, and IIM and IISs and IIT and all the IITs here. And not only that, you have several national institutes of repute, and Mahatma Gandhi University and Raman Research Institute. And not only that, you have Australian University Thesis and Dissertations, DART, and Divya Portal, and open access thesis and dissertations, and many more like that. In addition to that, you have patents and standards and various search engines which can help you browse through these ones. And not only that, you have virtual libraries and subject gateways. Well, yet another important portal is University of Delhi, which also started getting a lot of courses, teaching resources online, and we can get them subject wise because it's a huge resource. I had to chop them into in columns indicating various subjects from A to Z. You can search, you can get, like, you start from anthropology, biochemistry, it all goes in alphabetical order until zoology. You have wide number of subjects that had been gathered and stored in video lectures or on e-platforms. And that has been a great effort by the University of Delhi. Well, coming to yet interesting part and more interesting part of STEM subjects, I know that one is a common sense educator. Common sense educator is a whole new perspective on building blocks of a worldwide with these bricks and that shows the inner life of life itself. It always hard for students to grasp these kind of abstract concepts in science. So it's important to focus on developing scientific language proficiency and building models in the classroom. And these apps and games and websites on this list, get the students, tinkering with their simulations and playing games. And they provide teachers with a wealth of lessons and videos to tackle cell theory, genetics, biochemistry, and many more. And here I have identified many resources which are quite useful for all the teachers dealing with the STEM courses. And more importantly, the NOVA, which is which is comprised of compelling science videos that have a high quality classroom applications. And it has a lot of documentaries and it offers a window into real world scientific topics in a high interest way. And yet another one is a CK12. It's a super STEM social studies resource with highly customizable content. Yeah, making content accessible to kids with different learning styles, this CK12 could be a key and to mastery of some of interest subjects of interest to the students. Yet another resource that interested me is DIY Nano. That's do it yourself Nano. It turns the kids into a budding nano scientist. It makes them help explore the tiniest things. And these are all experiment based from the scientist review videos and activities related to nanoscience to everyday life. It's quite interesting and make the teacher and student very interesting to get into more details with the everyday nanoscience every day. Well, CellStrike is yet another resource and it helps identify how we can fight the infections on compelling biology-based missions. And it is a fun and very efficient way for the student to learn how competent the immune system can work and with the bonus lessons in strategy. Yet another resources are UHandy. It is a very interesting resource. It gives us a microscope attachment for the mobile device and helps us inspire as we get into the field investigations. The uses of stickers instead of slides help the student examine their world at that microscopic level with safety and also at convenience. Yet another one is NOVA Elements. This NOVA Elements is an information-packed science resource which is great for teaching and also teaching the elements. It is good for teaching teachers and also for the students. And it is an awesome tool that can be used to build knowledge, understanding, while keeping the students engaged in learning process. But the other one is the cell and cell structure. It is a visually stunning tool. It is great for supplementing lessons about the cells. It helps to study the cell and the cell structure in a very interactive and engaging way. And it makes the interest of the student turn on continuously. Well, Taito Online is yet another resource which makes the student very ambitious and role-playing game for the bright future. And it is very, I should say that this tool is very immersive. It contains immersive experiences and useful for teachers to use as a tool to make life science very interesting and thought-provoking and worth checking out. Well, further resources, if you probe into, Cell Command is very another important one. It's an immersive biology game. It keeps students interested during learning and it makes the student take away with a broad knowledge of cell anatomy and its functions. Well, yet another one is cell energy and photosynthesis lab. And it is very interactive resource, also now, and it helps the student interact with the carbon cycle lab and deepen the student understanding as the students start working on it. The next is the molecular workbench, regularly updated on resource features with great simulations and biomolecules at different modules. And it is a good handy tool for the teachers. And it gives the teacher the time to prepare. And these are the great resources for just about any science classroom. And yet another one is learn.genetics. Learn.genetics is a multimedia resource for budding biologists. It helps the teachers and the students to find out a lot of useful multimedia stuff, you know, multimedia curriculum, and help them to understand the complex genetic topics. Well, then there's the Nova Labs. Yet is another online scientific resource, and it is exceptional with its content, with a very useful tasks given from tough topics, and it is very serious and sophisticated science engagement. And you know, a teacher need to be prepared, take some time in preparation before they could connect to the class, but very, very useful. And it is an exceptional tool, teaching tool for the teachers. Well, in the STEM programs. Well, PrepMagic is a customized science simulation to highlight the phenomena. You can engage the student in various simulations customized to their respective experiments. Remission 2 is yet another one. It is a 6 arcade style game and which can tackle through tough subjects of cancer. It helps the student engage in gameplay while grabbing a lot of knowledge and learning about human body. Well, next one is the P-Table. It's a very, very interesting teaching resource online, definitely about the periodic table and with all the bells and whistles. And the student find it very interesting and very encouraging, and you know, grabbing the student's interest while the student gets into this particular resource. Well, you make, you know, yet another one is a You Make Me Sick. This is yet another dramatic way to teach the kids about the spread of germs. This resource will engage the student, engaging them and making them very informative. And, you know, both for the teachers and also for the students in the spread of the germs by letting the players take the side of the germs. Bio-interactive. This is a high quality multimedia and which brings biological research to life. It talks about the tools and lesson plans that helps the kids explore biology through real world examples. So course and education, this is yet another one. It makes the student think like a scientist, solves biology case studies, and it involves the student in problem solving skills and encourage them to learn many biological problems through interactive case studies. Well, the yet another one is Eterna, clearly spelling about RNA. This Eterna is about RNA designing game and which can lead to several scientific discoveries. And the student will enjoy the mix of puzzles, solving and creating, and will learn some science along with the way of designing new discoveries. But at the same time, if they're lost, they put them in awkward situations too. But however, inspired student, though the students are much interested in RNA studies, they can create some hypothetical scientific discoveries using Eterna. Well, Citable. These are very useful teacher tools, and where the articles are cited, which are useful for the advancement of their studies and also for the advanced bio students. It's a good resource for the teachers looking to make the virtual classroom and the articles on current issues and you know and the science and the scientific news connecting for the most advanced studies and the current trends in the scientific studies. Well, MetaBlast is a biology game, wealth of information and helps for the finders, you know, and it's a great learning potential, not yet but based delivered in the way that will help the student get onto the board. The last one is the Foldit. Foldit is yet another challenging teaching resource, helps the teacher and the student also in making the student understand the puzzle behind the very essence of the folding of the proteins, the challenges in the protein folding and the complexity in the protein folding, and thereby deriving the function, the structure and the function of the protein. Well, so these are the various teaching resources are of great use for the teacher and also helps the student in a self-learning way. Yet another one is the Cell and Molecular Biology online, where you can find them in cellbio.com. It has a great educational resources, and you have the Access Excellence and Beyond Bio 101, BioChemNet, which focuses on biology, chemistry, and BioZone. It provides an outstanding collection of coverage of biology, cell biology, genetics, health, disease, animal biology, ecology, and space biology, and bugs in use. This also gives us a kind of fun site featuring the series of essays on viruses, bacteria, diseases, and basic biological processes. Yet, some more resources online are the free biology apps, and which can be found at the bioexplorer.net. Some of the 23 best free biology apps have been named here, where you can access them at bioexplorer.net. Then the 23 ones are the animal anatomy and physiology, cell biology, internal organs in 3D, learning biology basics, medicinal plants, scientific binomial name, microbiology, visual anatomy, human anatomy, touch surgery, microbiology, smart guide, bioblock studying, best free science quiz, 3D brain, biology quiz, Attenborough story of life and the wildlife, infectious diseases, neat biology apps, complete biology, skeptical science, biology ebooks, Khan Academy, and biology. So these are the best free biology apps or the resources that can be found on the bioexplorer.net. If you go a little deep into it, I have 30 minutes of time. Let me cover as much as I can, because I bought in a huge amount of teaching resources that can be accessed during this online period of education or the pandemic period. Well, let's get into that. I have just 13 minutes more. Let me look into more of it. In animal anatomy and physiology, this summarizes on the gross anatomy and morphology of the animal body, as well as its functions and its process. The very book itself is divided into various chapters like cell, body organization, hormone, chemicals, and different body systems. It is a perfect for reviewing dissection, and it makes use of the animal encountered in veterinary medicine as examples. When it comes to Cell Biology 101, that helps us to unlock the morphological and molecular mysteries of cell using this amazing mobile app. And this basically features on various lessons, quizzes, and practice sessions over all the cell anatomy and physiology. Well, if you see for the internal organs and 3D, which is another wonderful app, you know, it'll help you love watching the surgeries or just the fond of studying internal organs. And this app is perfect for you. And you know, the internal organs 3D biology app that features the 3D model of the internal organs of the human body. You can even, the special feature is that you can even touch each organ like the brain, heart, lungs, stomach, liver to see more information and detail about the morphological descriptions. Yet another one is the biology basics that will help you explain, I mean, greatly on the basics and foundations of the topics of biology, such as environment, basic botany, zoology, different types of pollution, concept of evolution, and many more. And it has also advanced topics like molecular and cell biology, as well as genetics and variations, and many more. Well, about the medicinal plant app, any beginner can get into this app and get to know the various benefits of the medicinal plant, the uses of the medicinal plants, the harmful chemicals that have been, that can come from them, or the experiencing in the effects, and you know, and many more like that, including their identification and significant features. But like yet another one resource is the scientific binomial names. Any layman, any student can access this one. And I mean, those who have a love for taxonomy, they can access this one and start identifying and learning the naming and the classifying organisms and the way or the keys that are used in naming and in the classification. And not only that, it makes you feel like a scientist and who can scientifically name the organisms in your surroundings. And you know, this is very interesting app and makes the taxonomy feel very interesting even for a beginner to play with and also start naming in accordance with the keys that are used for the other apps. Now, for the microbiology 2017, yet is another great resource. This is specifically made for the students enrolled in microbiology courses with non-majors. And this features special reviews and lectures, as well as graphics about microbiological principles and techniques. Apart from that, you have, you know, from lectures, it also serves as a good refresher since it features various practice questions and quizzes. It has chapters and highly recommended if you want to learn the fundamentals and the basics of microbiology. Well, visual anatomy, which is a very, I mean, interesting, I mean, resource, which is free and very interactive. And you can always see that how many people have already started using this app, and it helps you identify the human body in three-dimensional models. And apart from that, it also gives a short description about each tissue and organ, both in morphology and its functions. And it has also an audio pronunciation command, which is helpful for the medical professionals, personals, academicians, and even the students who are studying biology in general. Well, it is human anatomy. It is very interesting, yet another app. It helps to study the particular body systems, giving him or her a detailed description about the organs. And the touch surgery is very, very interesting app for doctors, not only for the doctors, yet for every student who wanted to learn about the surgeries, looking ways, I mean, to practice surgery at the comfort of your hands, own hands. And, you know, the touch surgery, you know, it's a surgical simulation app that allows its user to perform the operation on patients. Aside from its impressive three-dimensional graphics, this app also allows the user to trace its learning progress. That's very interesting. Yeah, that microbiology smart guide. Well, I have 7 minutes more. Well, this actually, as said, you know, it's a smart guide that helps you identify the terminologies, learn from them, and the name the scientists and their discoveries. Well, BioBlocks is yet very interesting for the people who are interested in the structural biology that help you understand the ligands, the receptors, by switching, rotating, and swiping, and creating wonderful matches, and understanding the structure, function, relation of the proteins, and their with their ligands and their receptors. This BioBlocks is a very interesting app. Well, this is the best, free science quiz for the students to practice their knowledge. If you know that you have learned enough, there's a site for you. There's an important resource for you where you can practice and challenge your knowledge. And also not only that, you can even improve your knowledge by using this particular resource. Well, 3D Brain is yet another app that help you understand the different structures and functions of the brain. And it can help you zoom in and rotate and touch and see the various regions of the brain. And also not only that, you can parallelly study the various diseases or the disorders that are associated with the different parts of the brain and the other scientific research that are related to the brain. Well, the biology quiz. Well, in this biology quiz that helps you practice in the various fields of biology, aside from that of a lot of trivia presented in a humorous manner in order to prevent you from getting bored. And therefore, this is a good resource where along with the teacher, students can also practice and also implement it in their virtual classrooms to make the classroom very lively and vibrant. Yes, yet this is another Attenborough's life story of life. You know that he's a famous broadcaster and a naturalist, David. After his name, this series has been built up. And, various collection of films about the wildlife, as well as the product of his 6-decade career on studying nature have been documented through this, wildlife series. There was David Attenborough's, app. Well, yet another one is about the infectious diseases. This helps us to understand the health, disease, facts, tips, update, and review on HIV infection, AIDS, and much more for the students. This provides a wealth of information on health and general education, medical recommendations, and kind conditions that promote the spread of the diseases and the various preventive measures that can be taken up through this particular resource. And biology neat inspection is yet another resource for the students where they can help prepare for their national eligibility entrance test. It not only covers the biology, it also covers the chemistry and physics too. It has all the explanations, illustrations, features, diagrams, flow charts. Not only that, several practice tests, it thoroughly prepares the students to take up the biology NEET exam. Yet another resource is a complete biology. And this one talks about the basic biology and its preparations, and it makes the student prepare to compete for the examinations. It has 35 different biology topics covered under different categories. And skeptical science, it helps the user to respond to false statements and claims about global warming by using information from the peer-reviewed scientific studies, which is a very, very unique in all the resources that so far has been dealt. And further ones are the biology ebooks and quizzes, and more importantly is the Khan Academy. Khan Academy is very popular among the student and also the teaching fraternity, because the Khan Academy covers a wide range of topics, both from STEM and also from the social sciences. Well, these days, we also have to focus on the virtual labs. Yet, for the virtual labs for physics, chemistry, cell and molecular biology, you can find a worthy resource, tons of worthy resource at labster.com. It has all these simulations, touching upon the various important aspects from physics, chemistry, cell and molecular biology. For example, few glimpses I have taken for you, like the radioactive decay. You have a wonderful simulation on this one, and you can have a virtual lab practiced on that one. And the law of universal gravitation, and from the general physics, and then material science and neutrons, where you can observe what happens inside the battery, which is taken from the general physics. And from the chemical sciences, you can see that, you know, the checking on a virtual lab on the carbon valence, hybridization, angles. Yet another one is ceric ammonium nitrate test. And you can go for the electrophilic addition, explore reactions of hydrocarbons and elimination reaction, using cyclohexanol to create polymers. You can use our virtual simulations to understand how we can create polymers using these reactions. Yet for the engineering virtual labs, few we have collected, like, you know, from the Ministry of Education. So the vlab.co.in, you can find various virtual labs that have been created for the mechanical engineering stream. And there are so many other additional online teaching resources. Well, to end, because my time is already done, yet to complete, you know, to close the session, I just wanted to propose one thing. For all the academicians in this current pandemic, this is a global game change. And at all levels, be it from the school to the PG level. Yet in one, you know, I came across this clipping in a recent WhatsApp where the CEO of Nokia says that, you know, we did not do anything wrong, but somehow we lost. The reason behind is, if you do not change, you will be disqualified from the competition. If you do not want to learn the new things and your thought and mentality stays old, and you'll end up with time. So that's the biggest challenge before the teachers, that is, you know, going virtual and blended mode of teaching. So unless we catch up with all the competencies at the global platform, we will have to stay behind. And, you know, so therefore it is a biggest challenge before us to explore the maximum number of resources online. Not only that, creating more resources for the coming up generations to learn as much as they can. And this virtual mode of education and the blended mode of education make the, education, the knowledge, the worth, and, you know, billions and millions of, you know, worths of, I mean, worthy knowledge made accessible to each and every student, provided they have a small gadget on hand with the internet. Therefore, this session, I'm sure this session must have presented the wealth of knowledge before you to explore further, to face, to take up this global game change. And this is for all the teachers at all levels. Thank you for your attention.
Ma'am, questions are there, ma'am. I'll just read it for you. One of the participants has asked, do we have easy access to these websites, or should we buy or have some memberships?
Yeah, that's very important question. If you make, you know, certain resources are free, and many of the countries have come forward to make their resources free online these days. Earlier, for example, 3 years ago, these resources need to be purchased. But you find several Harvard resources, MIT resources, Cambridge resources, Stanford resources free online, because they want to enable the student and the teacher to reach each and every resource. Well, apart from that, there are certain paid programs. If the university or the institution can subscribe, yes, that can be freely available by all the, made accessible to all the teachers and the student online. Yet there are certain resources which need to be purchased, and which goes for graduation purpose also. It can go for, evaluation, examination, evaluation, and awarding of the degrees. But certain things, yes, you need to enroll and purchase, yet at a very affordable prices. And I need to say that this pricing is always negotiable. If you talk on institutional terms, yes, we can always negotiate and come for a less, and made accessible at a lesser price.
Ma'am, next question, ma'am. Are the virtual labs user-friendly or require some specific?
Many of the virtual labs are user-friendly. Once you have a basic knowledge of on your subject expertise, yes, you can, I'm sure you can always log into and use it as per the instructions given. But however, certain labs need a specific themselves provide what need to be downloaded before you access it. So as you go into, you can always go through the instruction, download the necessary things, and you know, access only through the trusted website, access only through its actual home site, and then download whatever the necessary the things, what do you say, nuggets or whatever, you download them so that you can access and start playing with the virtual labs. Next.
Okay, ma'am. Any more questions from the participants? You can keep it in the chat box.
And I could only complete half part what I have actually collected online resources for you. I can leave this, share this one with the organizers. So you can through this, URLs and where the resources are available and get benefited.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you. We appreciate that, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much.
Ma'am, with so much of content and online courses available, is online degree equivalent to the normal degree?
There are terms and conditions prescribed. ODLs are very, very, made very strict and stringent. And very, I need to say, very serious study. If you want to know, there are different levels. Free, if you want to study free and get a certificate free, that's fine. If you want to get seriously evaluated and get a serious certificate, yes, there are certain declarations need to be given. Sit with us, give your attention and attendance of the classes and also participate in the discussions. Give a proctored examination, get evaluated and get an evaluated degree. That is more valid. So all these terms and conditions will be mentioned in the certificate, showing the worth of it. There are Coursera contents available freely done, and as much as they're free and you do it freely, and the worth is again a liberal one, okay? But you know, there are paid content courses where you have a serious program and the value is also credited, and this credit are evaluated and they're also taken into the curriculum. So there are different modes. You should get into the thing and enroll yourself as per your requirement. It is customized. If you want to just enroll just to enrich your knowledge, fine. You can always go for a free course and enrich your knowledge. If you want to go for credits, enrich for a course, enroll for a course, get through the proctored examination, get evaluated, get the credits done, and submit the credits that can be added up to your academic score bank.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
I request Dr. Rosalind, Department of Microbiology, St. Francis College, to give the VOTEC thanks for this session.
Thank you, Sunita. On behalf of Departments of Microbiology, Biochemistry and Biotechnology, St. Francis College for Women, I take this honor to thank our eminent resource person, Professor Mamata Dadala, Registrar, Sri Padmavati Mahila Vishwavidyalayam, and Fulbright Scholar, USA. We are grateful to you, ma'am, for sparing your time to enlighten the participants about various resources for teaching science. Thank you for giving us an insight into massive open online courses, hybrid MOOCs, BombayX, IITX, ePathashala, and also highlighting the importance at college and university level. Websites like commonsense.org, Nova Compelling, the science videos, CK12, SuperSTEM resource, CellStrike, DIY Nano, UHandy, Taito, many, many more resources shared by you will definitely make teaching more interesting, interactive, and effective. Thank you very much, ma'am, for sharing with us the ample and bountiful resources. And this we are going to definitely use to make online teaching very effective. We're grateful to you, ma'am, for an enriching session and sharing the wealth of resources. Thank you once again, ma'am.
Thank you all.